There are times when attorneys need to make an invoice before receiving a payment. What happens if we provide a service before getting paid? Well, the client still owes the money, and the attorney still earned the money. Therefore, you should still make an invoice, but the results in your books and records will be different. Of course, income from legal fees would go up, because if you're making an invoice, you earn the income. But it would not be the unearned retainer fees that decreases in this case. If you do it that way, then unearned retainer fees would not be correct. So you have to be careful to do it differently. In a case like this, income from legal fees would still go up, but it would be a different account called legal fees receivable, which represents what the attorney actually earned and will receive in the future. And if you make an invoice and never got paid for that invoice, it is this account, legal fees receivable, that will go up because it represents what is earned and not yet paid. Legal fees receivable is an accounts receivable type of account. Let's add it to the chart of accounts before we do our first transaction. From the main menu, click Lists, Chart of Accounts. From the bottom left of the Chart of Accounts window, click Account, New. Then in the bottom center of the New Account, Choose Account Type window, come down here and choose Accounts Receivable. Notice QuickBooks specifically tells you an accounts receivable type of account is money customers owe you on unpaid invoices. Click Continue and confirm that in the Add New Account window, accounts receivable is the account type. The name of the account will be Legal Fees Receivable. Legal Fees Receivable. Click Save and Close, and now we have a second accounts receivable type of account in the chart of accounts, and that's the one we will use when we make invoices before receiving payments. Now let's look at an example. February 17, we have to create invoice number 5 for Candy Charles for a legal service provided on that same day, February 17. And the service was worth $900. She did not yet pay. Candy owes the money. We can print the invoice for Candy, but make sure when you make the invoice that you choose the legal fees receivable account. So, we click Invoice from the icon bar. We choose the customer, Candy Charles, as our client. We go forward in time to February 17th of 2017. Of course, QuickBooks remembers we're up to invoice number 5. And because we don't track our income, we only have one item for legal fees. Now, the most important thing that you have to look at this moment is up here. A moment ago, this field was not here in the invoice window because a moment ago, we only had one accounts receivable type of account. Now we have two, so QuickBooks put this field here, and we're going to choose this one, legal fees receivable, because the invoice has not yet been paid. When we click Save and Close, we can look at the trial balance, and we can see income from legal fees has still increased by the $900 we earned, but legal fees receivable shows up for the first time as $900. If you want to be sure that the $900 is also included in income from legal fees, you can double-click the total and look at every transaction that's included in the income from legal fees account. And when you go all the way down, you can see this $900 for February 17th is included. Now, you may well ask, what is the result in our client records? Well, If we look at the open invoice report, we can see that this invoice is standing alone as the only thing making a balance for candy, and it must be still unpaid because it's on the open invoice report. So the other clients have a negative balance because they have not yet used up their payments. But Candy has a positive balance because she has not yet paid the invoice. The more interesting report in this case is the client balance detail. Because notice, originally Candy's balance was negative, but little by little, Candy's balance went positive because we kept doing so much work for her that we did so much work that she did not yet pay for some of the work done. It's very, very important that you watch how to receive payment against an invoice that has never been paid. Let's imagine on February 25th, Candy paid Ross half of what she owes for the February 17th invoice. That means she paid us $450, and let's imagine she paid with check number 1212. Make sure you choose the legal fees receivable account. So how do we do this? Well, we open the payment window, we choose Candy the client, we put the date that she paid, February 25th, and of course we put the check number of the check that she paid. Now, we're going to put the $450, and on the left of your keyboard, when we push the tab key, QuickBooks will place the check mark in the only open invoice because QuickBooks assumes that it's being applied to that invoice. It's the only one there. But the most important thing you have to double check before you click save and close is that the correct accounts receivable account is chosen. Since invoice number 5 was put into the legal fees receivable account, that means when you apply a payment to invoice number 5, you also choose the legal fees receivable account. Now click save and close, and when we look at our trial balance, you can see legal fees receivable has decreased from $900 to $450. You can double click, and you can see that it was $900, and then on the 25th, Candy made a $450 payment, decreasing the balance to $450. You will also notice that if you look at the open invoice report, only $450 out of the original $900 is still open on the open invoice report. And if you want to see more information about this $450 and this invoice number 5, double click, and then you can click Reports, Transaction History, and you can see it was $900. But then on February 25th, we applied a $450 payment to this invoice. The most interesting part of this entire situation is really shown on the client balance detail. Notice her balance was negative, then it became positive, now it's going closer back down to zero as she pays.